Umeshinda ni yangu. Oni wewe unayeishi ndani yangu. Ni wewe unayeishi ndani yangu. Oh, nakupenda, nakupenda sana. Umenifanya ibada ni kuabudu. Umenipa kutumika chini ya pendo lako. Umenifanya ibada ni kuabudu. Umenipa kutumika chini ya pendo lako. Mamlaka na nguvu ninazo kufanya lolote utakalo. Mamlaka na nguvu ninazo, mana we upo ndani yangu. Mana we upo ndani yangu. Umenifanya ibada ni kuabudu. Umenipa kutumika chini ya pendo lako. Umenifanya ibada ni kuabudu. Umenipa kutumika chini ya pendo lako. Mamlaka na nguvu ninazo kufanya lolote utakalo. Mamlaka na nguvu ninazo, mana we upo ndani yangu. Mana we upo ndani yangu. Umeniweka sirini mwako Bwana, nikujue zaidi ya fahamu zangu. Umeniweka sirini mwako Bwana, nikujue zaidi ya fahamu zangu. Mamlaka na nguvu ninazo kufanya lolote utakalo. Mamlaka na nguvu ninazo, mana we upo ndani yangu. Mana we upo ndani yangu. Asanti Yesu kwa kuishi ndani yangu. Oh Christ in me, oh Christ in me, the hope of glory. Asante Yesu. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Nasema ndio, ndio. Nasema ndio, ndio. Nasema ndio, naamini. Ndio. Nasema ndio kwa neno lako. Ndio. Ndio Bwana. Bwana. Ndio Bwana. Bwana. Ndio Bwana. Bwana. Ndio Bwana. Bwana. Ninasema ndio. Ninasema ndio. Ninasema ndio. Se ma Dio. Ni na se ma Dio. Dio. Dio Bwana. Bwana. Dio Bwana. Bwana. Dio Bwana. Bwana. Dio Bwana. Hey. Bwana. Oh, 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 oh. Hallelujah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Dio Bwana. Oh, naishi ndani yangu. Pokea heshima na utukufu wewe. Unaishi ndani yangu. Uliye ndani yangu hata sasa. Uliye ahidi hutoniacha. Uliye ahidi hutoniacha. Oh, unaishi ndani yangu. Roho Mtakatifu ndani yangu. Kila siku ndani yangu. Anayeniongoza kila siku, kila wakati. Yeah, yeah. Oh, simtafuti huko nje, anaishi ndani yangu. Mungu ndani yangu. Nimebeba Mungu ndani yangu. Tumebeba Mungu ndani yetu. Oh, 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 oh. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ni siku kuu, siku ile ya kumkiri Mwokozi. Moyo umejaa tele, kunyamaza hauwezi. Kukesha na kuomba tu, ananiongoza miguu. Siku kuu, siku kuu ya kuoshwa dhambi zangu tu. Tumekwisha kupatana mimi wake, yeye wangu. Na sasa nina tamwandama nikiri neno la Mungu. Kukesha na kuomba tu, ananiyo goza miku. Siku kuu, siku kuu ya kuoshwa dhambi zangu. Kukesha, kukesha na kuomba tu, ananiyo goza miku. Siku kuu, siku kuu ya kuoshwa dhambi zangu tu. Moyo tulia kwa Bwana, kiini cha raha yako. Huna njia mbili tena, Yesu ndiye raha yako. Kukesha na kuomba tu, ananiyo goza miku. Siku kuu, siku kuu ya kuoshwa dhambi zangu tu. Kukesha na kuomba tu, ananiyo goza miku. Siku kuu, siku kwa shwada bizangu siku ku ya kwa shwada bizangu siku ku ya kwa shwada bizangu ku. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, 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 yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Siku ku, yako shwada, bizangu kukesha na kuomba tu ananiyo. Ya kwa shwada bizangu tu na bizangu ku. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, ni siku ku. That day when all my sins were washed away. And on that day, Jesus came and dwell and chose to dwell in me. Holy Spirit in me. Father and Jesus and the Holy Ghost in me. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we don't serve a God who is far away. Oh, our God is He. Our God is He. Oh, our God is He. Our God is He. Oh, our God is not far away. Our God is right here. Right here in us. Right here in us. Right here in us. He will never leave us. He'll never leave us. He will never forsake us. Oh, it's amazing grace. Oh, it's such an amazing grace.
Grace
that the King of Glory will dwell in me.
Amazing love.
Oh,
it's unfailing grace.
Oh,
it's unfailing love.
Who breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of Glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the old earth, holy thunder, who lives breathless in awe and wonder. The King of Glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you will take my place. That you will bear my cross. You lay down your life. Then I will be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Who bring our chaos back into order. Who met the orphan as son and daughter? The King of glory, the King above all kings. Yeah. Who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of his brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all creation. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. Then you will take my place. Then you will bear my cross. You lay down your life. Then I will be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all of you done for me. All of you done for me. For all that you've done for me. For all that you've done for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. For all you've done for me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Oh, worthy. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. Then you will take my place. Then you will bear my cross. You lay down your life. Then I will be set free. Hey, hey, hey. Jesus is saying for all that you've done for me. Oh, oh, oh. Sing for all that you've done for me. Oh, 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 oh. Come on, lift up your hands where you were. Where you are, where you are, where you were, where you were. At your workplace, in your home. Hey, hey, hey. Come on, tell him worthy, 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 worthy. Come on, worship him right now, worship him right now. Come on, bless his name, bless his name. Oh, he's worthy, oh, he's worthy. Oh, he's worthy, he's worthy, he's worthy. Yeah. Nobody like him, nobody like him. Come on, begin, begin to worship. Begin to press in, press in right now. Press in right now. Hey, hey, hey. Oh, bless Jesus, bless Jesus, bless Jesus. Bless his name, bless his name, bless his name. Oh, is worthy, is worthy, is worthy, is worthy. Oh, is worthy, is worthy, is worthy. Come on, in your own tongue, in your own language. Bless his name. Shali ya la 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 la. Shali ya la 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 la. Shali ya la 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 la. Shali ya la 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 la. Shali ya la 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 la. Shi la 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 la. Come on, give him thanks, 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 give him thanks. Oh, shalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalal presence has been with us. Oh, the God who dwells among his people. The God who dwells in his people, in his people. Oh, but is your temple. To dwell, to dwell, to dwell, to dwell. Oh, we are that living temple that God dwells, that God dwells. And we rejoice, and we rejoice. God in us right now. God in everybody, God in everyone who believes. Oh, and we rejoice in you, Jesus. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Oh, you're worthy to be worshipped. You're worthy of all the glory. You're worthy of all the honor. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. And we rejoice that the greater one lives inside of us. We rejoice, we rejoice, we rejoice. Nothing can come against us, for God lives inside of us. Thank you, Jesus. I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what come my way. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. Come on, wherever you are, clap your hands. Hey, 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 hey. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we serve a great God who is chosen to be in us, to be among us. Hey, ho, ho, ho. Sing, I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what comes my way. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm born a winner, more than victorious. I'm a heir of his kingdom, filled with the Holy Ghost. Oh, I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what come my way. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm born a winner, more than victorious. I'm a heir of his kingdom, Fill me the Holy Ghost. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him. I'm more than a conqueror. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him. More than a conqueror.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. No weapon, come on, say.
No weapon formed against me,
no sickness,
shall ever prosper. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm born a winner, more than victorious. I'm a heir of His kingdom,
joint heir,
filled with the Holy Ghost.
Come on, come on, come on.
No weapon, no weapon formed against me shall ever prosper. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm born a winner, more than victorious. I'm a heir of His kingdom, filled with the Holy Ghost. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in I rejoice in Him, more than a conqueror. I rejoice in Him.
Come on, rejoice.
I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him, more than a victorious.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Turn to that person around you and tell him, you are victorious.
You are victorious.
You are more than a conqueror.
You are more than a conqueror.
I'm
more than victorious.
More than victorious.
I am more than victorious.
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 You are more than a conqueror.
More than a conqueror.
You are more than a conqueror.
You are more than a conqueror.
Say, you're more than a conqueror.
You are more than a conqueror.
More than a conqueror. Say, rejoice
in Him. I rejoice in Him. Rejoice in Him, more than a conqueror. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him. I rejoice in Him, more than a conqueror.
Jesus, oh, yeah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Come on, open up your mouth and begin to thank Him for making you more than a conqueror. More than a conqueror. Not just a conqueror, but more than a conqueror. Not just a conqueror, but more than a conqueror. Not just a victor, but more than victorious.
Oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, o
Good morning and praise the Lord. It's a great pleasure to be with you once again. My name is Pastor Felix Onyango, coming to you from Dominion Assembly Church, Kiambu Road. It's great to have with me today for our service a great friend, a great brother, a great minister, Pastor Thaddeus Charlie, all the way from Papa Center Church on Mombasa Road. It's great to have you here, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for having me.
Amen. Would like to just get straight into the word this afternoon or this morning, depending on where and what time you're watching us or tuning in into this. The Bible says that Paul, when he writes to the Ephesians from Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 15, he says, after I've known, wherefore I also, after I had of your faith in the Lord Jesus and love unto all the saints, I cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you always in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, that the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who do believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places. Verse 21, far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. Amen. And I put all things, let's just finish verse 22, and I put all things under his feet and gave him to be the head over all things to the church. Amen. I would just like us to look briefly this morning at the topic, the hope of his calling. You know, right now with all that is going on, there's a lot of discouragement. There's a lot of anxiety. There's a lot of fear. There's a lot. And in the process, believers are asking themselves, what is this hope that we've been called to? What kind of hope is this that we have in him? Amen. The Bible says, Paul says that when I heard of your faith, I cease not to pray for you and pray that the Lord will give you the spirit of wisdom and understanding, that you may know what is the hope of his calling. Sometimes, brother or sister, when you know what is the hope that he's called you to, it helps to quieten you. It helps to put you at rest. It helps to give you strength in the midst of what you're going through, because you understand what is the hope. Not only the understanding the hope of his calling, but understanding who the caller is as well. Pastor, break it down for us in a bit as we get into this.
This hope we've been called to is first eternal. Everlasting.
That's right.
It has no ending. Mm-hmm. Once we have found Christ,
yes, sir,
we initiated into this eternal hope. Mm-hmm. It's everlasting, is enduring. Is eternal. That's why Paul is calling it. And this hope is not your hope.
Yes.
It's a hope of his calling. So the source of this hope, mm-hmm, is God.
Wow.
That's the source of this hope is Christ. It's not this, the source of this not hope. It's not in yourself.
That's right.
It's in him, mm-hmm, Christ. Mm-hmm. Because Paul is also talking and says that this Christ,
yes,
is your hope, mm-hmm, of glory. And why is, yes, this Christ?
Yes.
This Christ is in you. Mm-hmm. Christ in me, mm-hmm, is the hope of glory.
Yes.
Christ in you.
Right.
Is your hope of glory. So the significance of this hope is in whose hope is in our object of this hope.
Right.
Who is God?
Mm-hmm.
The object of our hope.
Interesting. That the source of this hope
is
and
God.
The object of our hope
is God.
Is God. So this hope is not, it's not a hope that, you said the hope is eternal.
It's eternal. It's everlasting.
I remember the writer of Hebrews, Hebrews 6, says, yes, this hope we have as an anchor of the soul. And it enters into that which is within the veil.
The veil.
Where Christ has
already
gone for us.
Yes.
So it's a hope that is not secured on the things of this world.
No.
If you look at Romans 11 and 36, verse 36,
yes,
the Bible says, for of him and through him, and to him, are all things. That this hope is the source.
It's Christ.
Is Christ.
Surely Christ.
And to him also are all things. Of him, it comes from him, is through him.
Is and is for him.
And is for him. Wow, interesting. I'd like us to just break this down a little bit further. When you look at the hope of his calling, yes, it's eternal. And it's Christ in us who is the hope of this glory. I'd like...
Our object of hope.
Yes.
So our hope is anchored,
yes,
on Christ.
Yes.
In Christ.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it's still St. Paul that speaks. And I think it's Corinthians. And through the scriptures, through the mm-hmm. consolation,
yes,
of the scriptures, we, yes, have hope.
Mm-hmm.
So this hope is also anchored,
yes,
in the word of God.
In the word of God.
Because the scriptures,
yes,
cannot be broken.
Wow. So the scriptures cannot be broken. This hope is not only from God.
Is of God.
Is of God.
In God.
In God. And it's anchored
in him. And in his word.
The psalmist says, thy word, O Lord, forever thy word is settled
in the heavens.
In the heavens. So this is a hope that is an unmovable.
He's settled.
It's settled.
It's settled.
Wow.
It's unwavering.
Wow. I'm loving this. And if you look at 2 Peter verse 1, chapter 1, from verse 1, I would like us to read that. The Bible says, Simon Peter, a servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ, to them that have obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior Jesus Christ. Grace and peace be multiplied to you through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord.
I will want you to.
Let's go back to verse 2.
This is sweet. This scripture is very sweet.
Mm-hmm.
We want to do that to this scripture. Let's go back. Verse 1.
Yes.
It says, to them that have obtained like precious faith.
Yes, sir.
Us. Through mm-hmm. the righteousness of God and our Savior,
Jesus Christ.
So how do we obtain this precious faith?
Mm-hmm.
Through righteousness.
Yes.
Through the righteousness
of God.
Of God. So this is imputed,
right,
righteousness.
Yes, sir.
This has nothing to do with you.
Mm-hmm.
It
mm-hmm.
has everything to do with God.
With God.
And the Lord Jesus Christ. Continue. In verse 2 says, grace and peace... as one of God, grace,
yes,
and peace can be multiplied.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Even in these times.
Even in this time. Grace, God's empowerment. Grace, God's supernatural ability
mm-hmm.
to do that is beyond our natural ability
mm-hmm.
can be multiplied. And this peace, this mm-hmm. is the peace with God,
yes,
and the peace of God,
God
that transcends human understanding, can be multiplied.
Wow. Psalm verse 112,
yes,
the Bible says, I think verse 4, it says, unto the upright there arises light even in
darkness.
So even in the midst of the darkness and what is going on,
yes,
right now, sometimes people are looking for understanding.
Yes.
Even in the darkness, grace and peace, it's, they can arise light.
Light. In the midst of this darkness.
In the midst of this darkness.
And you find grace and peace that you can't explain. Paul says in Philippians 4,
right,
I think 6,
yes, sir,
and 7, be anxious
mm-hmm.
for nothing.
For nothing.
In all things, by prayer and supplications, make your requests known unto God, and the peace of God.
Of God.
That transcends, surpasses, supersedes,
mm-hmm.
superimposes,
wow,
over all things.
Yes,
shall guard your heart And I like that there's another translation that is, it will mount God.
Yes.
It will garrison.
Wow.
It will garrison your heart and your mind in Christ. That in moments like this,
yes,
in situations like this, you remain undeterred.
Anchored.
Anchored in this peace and this grace of God, which is multiplied.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Jesus. Take us to that.
Second Peter 1, verse 2. Yes, sir.
Glory to God. And grace and peace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God. So how do we get into this grace and this peace?
Yes.
Multiplication. By the knowledge of God. What is this knowledge of God? And Peter is talking about that through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. So they say, I need to come to a knowing. I need to come to a knowing of Christ.
Yes, sir.
To a knowing of God. Mm-hmm. To enjoy grace and peace. And it being multiplied over my life.
Yes.
It will take a knowing.
Knowing.
Not an information.
Yes. Because there's a lot of information going around right now.
A lot of information. This is not talking about information. This information talks about God.
Yes.
The knowledge we are talking about is of God. To know the things that are of God and the things you have in God.
And that's why we started by saying that I pray that you may have the spirit of wisdom.
Of wisdom.
And revelation.
In the knowledge of him. That the eyes of your understanding be enlightened that you may know.
Yes.
So, sir, are you telling me until the eyes of my understanding are enlightened?
Yes.
I cannot.
So it's not a mental knowledge. It's not academic.
It's not academic. It's not intellectual.
Intellectual knowledge. Yes. Yes.
This is a spirit.
Mm-hmm.
It goes beyond. It is the mind of Christ.
Yes, sir.
Finding expression in the life of the believer. To lay hold of what God has already given to the believer through Christ.
Yes.
And you have to come to accurate, intimate knowledge of these realities.
Wow.
And it is not automatic.
It's John who says from the days of John the Baptist until...
Luke 16. He says, from the days of John the Baptist, this kingdom of God is being preached, and every man presses
in
into it. So it's at one point it is entered into.
Yes.
At one point it's taken.
Yes.
At another point it's being entered into.
Yes.
Another dimension it is being pressed into. So it's not for the passive believer who will read scripture and expect the realities of scripture to find expression in them and through them just automatically because you read it.
Mm-hmm.
These are deeper workings of God and of the Spirit
as
you marinate on the Word, meditate on the Word until the Logos become Rhema, become Spirit.
Yes.
You become one with the Word you're reading. If that is when you get lay hold, you see it.
Mm-hmm.
John 1:1. These are the things we have
heard.
These are the things we have seen. And these are the things we have handled of the word of life. We can't but.
Mm.
But there are realities beyond. This is not information.
Yes, sir.
This is not accumulation of knowledge as we know it.
Mm-hmm.
This is accurate,
intimate
knowledge of God and his workings. Mm-hmm. Once a believer comes into the encounter with this revelation knowledge,
yes, sir.
These things that Peter is talking about.
Grace and peace.
Grace and peace.
But automatically multiply. But you know the interesting thing, or the good thing with God, is that he says, I think 1 Corinthians 2, where he says, for who knows the things of a man except the spirit of man in him? Then he says, even so, the things of God knows no man.
But the spirit of God, who is with God?
Then he says,
but
yes,
he He has revealed them to us.
He has given us the same spirit.
Wow. That we may know.
That we may know the things
freely given to us of God. Then he said, no eye has seen, no ear has heard.
Yes.
It has not entered in the hearts of men. The things that God has prepared for them that love him, mm-hmm. but they have been revealed to us by his spirit. Then he finishes the chapter by saying, but you have the mind
of Christ.
Of Christ. To know. But this mind of Christ must be put to work.
Yeah. And it takes us back to what you're saying.
Yes.
Every man presses
in.
So the grace and peace will be multiplied through the knowledge of God.
Of God.
But we have a responsibility
to press in.
To press into it. Wow, this is sweet. Just seeing how much God has packed in. Let's go to verse 3 so that we stay on track with this.
We continue to verse 3 of, yes. According as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain to life
and godliness.
Pastor. You know, this is scripture that I feel like screaming. That according to God's divine
power,
he, without you demanding of him, out of his will, free will, he decided to give you everything that pertains to this life and to God. So he's not giving you.
Yes.
He has already given you.
He has already given.
But this is all, every time I read this, I begin to ask myself this question.
Yes,
if God, by according to his divine power, irresistible power, unstoppable power, that goes beyond the explanation of created intelligence, has given me all things.
Yes.
Not some things. All things that pertain to this life I'm living in right now.
Yes.
And the life to come. Where is it? Where are those things? Where are those?
Before we come to that, and I want us to, I remember we were talking we were talking about systematic
theology. Yes. Precept upon precept, line upon line.
Yes. If you don't understand his divine power.
Yes.
You see, it says, according as his divine power has given unto us all things. If we could just break down that a bit, his divine power.
Ability of God.
Yes.
To do without you.
Yes.
But what only him can do.
Mm-hmm.
Eh?
Yes.
The capacity of God to perform his counsel without external supervision.
Wow.
This divine power. We actually have divine power. The capacity of God to perform his counsel without external supervision.
Yes.
This divine power is all God is and all what God can do.
Yes. So
I need to know that. If somebody said your perception of God is what you get from him.
Wow.
So if this is your God is weakly, is limited, is subject to matter, subject to issues, subject to circumstances.
Yes.
This power, your perception of your of God determines how much you think he can do.
That's right. Wow.
So according to his, I need to know.
Power. You need to know the power.
I need to know the power. How much can God do? How much can God do? If when I come to grips.
Yes.
When I wrap my mind and my spirit around what God can do. The things that are around me become insignificant.
And that's why I say exceedingly, abundantly,
above all that you can ever think. You can ask or think.
Yes.
That is Ephesians 3:20.
Yes.
According to the working
of his mighty power.
In the inside of you. Who is this power? 1 Corinthians. Is it 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 24? Check for me that scripture.
Mm-hmm.
I discovered this power. It's not just a force.
Yes, sir.
It's a person.
It's a person.
Are you there? But it's there. But unto them which are called.
Yes.
Are you called? both Jew
That's right.
and Gentile.
Yes.
Christ,
the power of God.
Power of God and
the wisdom
of God. Of God. Mm-hmm. The practicality of what God knows
mm-hmm. is wisdom. Wow.
That Christ has become both the power
mm-hmm.
and the wisdom of God.
Yes.
And where is this Christ? Christ is in, you,
in you,
the hope of glory.
Hope of
and
glory.
This Christ,
yes, sir.
This Christ,
mm-hmm.
this your God,
mm-hmm.
can do
mm-hmm.
now and to him. I
yes.
like the way it begins.
Yes.
Now, not tomorrow.
Yes.
In the midst of
now.
This now and
yes.
to God. This God we believe in now, not tomorrow, because God does not live. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He won't be better tomorrow than he is now.
Mm.
He's the same yesterday, today, and forever.
So now.
Now, this God.
Yes, sir.
Is not only able.
Mm-hmm.
He is here and able to do.
To do.
Able, present.
Yes.
Able.
Yes.
To do.
Yes, sir.
Exceedingly.
Abandoned.
Abundantly. Above. For those people have gone to school,
mm-hmm.
why would you put abundantly?
Yes.
Exceedingly. Above all. In one
sentence.
Then he says, according
yes, sir.
To the power that mm-hmm. worketh in the inside of me. This power is who?
Christ.
Christ.
Huh. Who is
and
also the hope.
Who is also the hope of glory. Who is the hunger of the soul?
Yes.
These are the realities we are calling to.
And that's why we started by saying that you may know the hope of his calling.
Yes.
Because if you know, you know, there's the time that Hezekiah they went out to war.
Yes.
I think 2 Chronicles 20.
Yes. Yes.
And the Lord gave him a word. And the Bible says the people rested themselves on the words of Hezekiah. These are words that you can anchor
you can
your soul.
Anchor your soul
in the midst of the turbulence.
In the midst of this turbulence.
Wow. Wow. So according as his divine power.
As he given us.
Yes. So once you've known
his divine power.
That power.
You can access all
things. All things that pertain to life
and
godliness.
Through the knowing of knowledge of him.
Before we even go to the knowing, he has given to us all things. You
nothing
said it earlier. He has given us all things richly.
Richly.
To enjoy.
Richly to enjoy. And Romans 8.
Yes, sir.
Is it Romans 8:29?
Mm-hmm.
He says, give us that scripture. Last it also. 29. 30.
I think it's further down.
Uh-huh. 31.
Next verse. Right there.
Verse 30. 32.
32.
He that spared not his own son.
Yes.
But delivered him
mm-hmm.
have for us all. How shall he not
with him
also freely
yes, sir.
Give us
all things.
You see that scripture, that how shall he not together with him, simply
yes.
put, as you collect Jesus,
mm-hmm.
you should also collect these all things.
Freely.
Freely, because he gave it together. So why collect Jesus and leave the things?
Oh,
glory to God.
He's given to us all
things.
Things.
All things.
Not he's given.
Not he's
he
given.
Has
oh, he's
given.
Going to give. No. He has done it. He's finished. He's not working.
Oh.
God is not working. God actually worked, finished, and he had his Sabbath.
That's why the writer of Hebrews says the works were
finished
before the foundation.
Before the foundations of the world.
The world. So now what we are walking into are works that were already finished. What
he
has laid up.
For our receiving. We don't ask God to do.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes man of God,
yes, sir.
Religion has dealt us a deadly blow. That you hear some of us in Christendom pray to make God do. I fear those people.
It's almost like we're trying to overcome God's reluctance.
Yeah. God, it's like, God, you are not doing it.
Yes.
So this, my prayer will move him so that he can do it. You must be too much, because he moved. Number one, Jesus is God's grand move.
Wow.
He moved. He's not going to move. He moved.
He moved.
Two, he worked.
Yes, sir.
He's not working. He created and he finished. And he looked at what he finished. He said, this looks fantastic. This my sons and my daughters can collect. And how do they collect? They have to come to the knowledge of what is I have finished.
Yes.
They have to come to the knowledge, practical, accurate knowledge of what is finished, what they are taking.
Yes.
And who has finished? Who is me? They need to know me, my ability to perform, and
it's divine
what has
power.
Been finished for their receiving. What is at their disposal? I want to quote one father in the faith. It's called Bishop Dr. David Oyedepo.
Yes, sir.
He said, if you don't know whose you are, and who you are, and what is at your disposal, you remain a fugitive.
Wow.
And I need to know whose I am, who I am in him, and what is at my disposal. For receiving, I will struggle in this life. Try to pray prayers to make God do what he already did. Try to make God move when he has already
moved. Wow. So he says, if we go back there, his divine power has given us all things. Second Peter 1:3.
Because we are using scripture to consult scripture.
Yes, sir.
To confirm scripture.
He has given us, his divine power has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. So we have all that we need for life and godliness. So there's no excuse to live a life that is below what he is.
No, we have no excuse.
Yes.
Jesus also was, scriptures are coming. Jesus was now talking to the Pharisees.
Yes, sir.
So now you guys, you have no excuse for your sin. Now we have many sin is missing the mark.
That's right.
So Jesus told them, you have no excuse.
For missing the mark.
You have no excuse now. Since I have come.
Yes.
Since Jesus is in you, you have no excuse for not becoming a recipient of all things that pertain to this life and to godliness.
That's the one who came full of grace.
Grace and
truth. The law by Moses came by
Moses. Grace and
truth came by Christ.
Are this grace upward?
Grace. So he says, you have all things that pertain to life and godliness. There's a lot here. We could unpack it a little bit more.
It's loaded.
But let's move on. Through the knowledge of him, once again, that's where we started. He said, grace and peace be multiplied
like
to you.
According to the
knowledge
of
him. So he says again, through the knowledge of him that has called us to glory and virtue.
You see, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
This through the knowledge of him, once you have come to the knowing of this divine power, what is this power? Who is this God?
Yes.
What is his capacity to perform?
Yes.
You remember Paul? Paul talking, I think, is it, can help me get the scripture?
Yes.
That I know him. I know him who I have believed. And I am persuaded that he is able to do, to keep
that which I've committed
to him. I know him.
I think it's 1 Timothy
chapter 1. I so know him.
Yes.
I am totally persuaded, no iota of doubt, that he is able to keep. So I need to know this knowing.
Yes.
When you get to this knowing, through that knowledge,
yes, sir.
That intimate, accurate knowing of who God is,
yes,
what he can do, what is at my disposal, who I am in him.
Yes.
Then he says, you will come to acknowledge
yes.
that you have been called to glory
and virtue. So
not to shame and reproach.
Yes.
Glory and excellence.
You know, there's a scripture that's coming in Hebrews 2 verse 9. It says, in bringing many sons to glory.
To glory.
Let's have it, then we'll come back here.
We can go all the way to 11.
Yes, Hebrews 2 verse 9. 9
to 11. Actually, 11 and 2. So Hebrews.
Hebrews, please.
2. Hebrews.
But we see Jesus,
who was made a little lower than the angels for the suffering of death, crowned with glory and honor, that he, by the grace of God, should test death for every man.
Mm-hmm.
Death had been tested for me. I don't need to test. For it became him, for whom are all things, for whom are all things,
all things,
and by whom are all things, and by whom, yes. through him.
In him all things consist, and by, okay, in, just go on.
In bringing many sons to glory, not to shame.
Yes.
Christ's death was to bring many sons to glory. He's the only son. You know, these songs we sing, Jesus is the only son of God. It's not true.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is the only begotten son of God.
That's right.
That the seed of the begotten son, God will bring himself many sons. By the seeding, by the seed of this one begotten son. Many sons are born into glory. To make the captain of their salvation perfect through suffering. Continue verse 11. Now this is true. For both he
that sanctifies.
That's a read that scripture.
For both he that sanctifieth and they who are sanctified are all of one.
That is dangerous.
For which cause is not ashamed to call them brethren. Break it down.
Jesus.
Yes, sir.
That you and Jesus now share. You have become all of one.
Of
you
one.
Share one Father.
Yes.
The Father Source. Of all glory.
Mm.
The Father of all power.
Yes.
He says, he's the all-wise God.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus. So if Jesus, by redemption, has initiated you into the family of the all-wise God.
Wow.
Then Jude is saying, Jude has only one chapter.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it the last verse?
Mm-hmm. To him that is able to keep you from falling.
From falling. It's the last verse.
Yes.
Only wise God.
Go back to verse 24.
No. I don't want that. Go to 26.
26.
To the only wise. To the only. You see. Our Father.
Yes.
He's the only wise God.
Mm-hmm.
He's the only wise God. The rest are mumus. The rest are fools. There's no sense elsewhere.
Yes.
God is the only wise God.
Yes.
Our Savior. Be glory and majesty, dominion and power both now and for this God is our Father. Jesus and us have become of one. This Father.
Yes.
Jesus makes this audacious statement
that
he's not ashamed
to call
you his brother.
Wow. We're joint heirs.
Joint heirs, I don't mean co-heirs.
Mm-hmm. Could you talk about that for a minute?
Joint heir, a co-heir. If you are my co-heir,
yes.
Is you take 50. I take 50.
You take
50. We share half.
Mm.
Joint heirs is you take 100% and I take 100%.
and that's why we are saying this is not intellectual knowledge.
So we are not sharing. this we are not sharing God's inheritance.
Mm-hmm.
It is all of me the way it is all of Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus. It is all of me.
Yes.
The way is all of Jesus. That's why he told Mary in the garden after the resurrection, go tell my brothers
Yes.
Go tell my brothers and Peter.
Yes.
Before I died, I called them friends.
Yes.
Because I could tell them what the Father has revealed, my Father has revealed to me. Mm-hmm. After I have gone to the cross and died and resurrected, I come back not as their friend. I'm their brother.
Wow.
My Father has become
their Father.
They are now my brothers. Simply put, all that I have in God, they have all it. Not some of it.
Wow.
So I have secured all of God.
Yes.
And all in God for them. I've given them.
Wow.
So if I can't, they take 100, I take 100. We are not sharing. Everything the Father has is theirs. Everything the Father has is mine. Don't you see Paul saying that Jesus, it pleased the Godhead, that it pleased the Father, that the fullness of the Godhead will tabernacle in Jesus' bodily. And then Jesus makes this another audacious statement that he is the body, he is the head of the body, the church, which is the fullness of him.
Oh, Jesus. Wow.
This is too much.
I wanted us to...
God, take us to that. We are in Peter.
Back this to second Peter.
I'm making this scripture very powerful.
Verse 3.
Through the knowledge of him. Now, we were just talking about through the knowledge of this him, Christ.
Yes.
See what he has made us. Who he is to us. What he has made us. And what he has given us access to.
Called us to glory.
And virtue.
And virtue.
No shame. So if I find shame in my life,
I need to interrogate my knowledge of him.
If I can adjust my knowing, I will change my experience.
Wow. If I can adjust my knowing, I will change my experience. So the problem is not the experience.
It's not the experience. It's your knowing.
It's your knowing. And that's why the Bible says, Daniel says, those who know their God
shall be strong and
do exploits. Now, the strength is a byproduct
of knowing. But also, this knowing is work.
And that's why
he says the people that do know their God. this knowing is not. Someone said,
yes,
and I may want to make this audacious statement. That everything of God is available for everybody. But it's not accessible
to everybody.
He does not decide access. He has decided.
Wow. So everything of God is available
for
everybody.
Including you.
Yeah. But it does not guarantee
access. You decide that.
Yes. Wow. So instead of sitting there and complaining,
yes,
and blaming and murmuring,
and shifting,
the wise thing to do
is to sit down
with the scriptures
by the help of the Holy Spirit.
Go
after what he has given you. The moment you see it, there's no way you will see something and not take it.
Wow.
If today I told you, go to QuickMart. At the electronic side,
yes,
it's a 55-inch television. It's gray in color.
Right.
I have bought it, paid it for you to collect.
Mm-hmm.
Then you, if you don't know what an LG brand television looks like.
That's right.
And you don't know what color gray looks like.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know what the specs I already mentioned. You don't know the features in that. When you go there, will you get it? Is the problem me?
There's somebody who said in the marketplace, he said a fool with a roadmap would get there faster.
Yes.
Than a genius without a roadmap.
Without a roadmap.
So understanding, knowledge, helps you to access
to access
what has been availed
for you.
So it takes you from the point of just knowing that there's availability to access
how to get
to access. Wow. Just to throw this in the Ecclesiastes, the place where it says the labor of the fool wears him out because he doesn't know
how
to get to the city. Oh, I need us to bring this to a close, man of God.
Yes, yes. And we go to verse 4.
Verse 4, quickly.
Whereby are given unto us.
Exceeding.
Whereby are given, already given.
Yes.
Unto us. Nobody is exempt here. Unto us. Even you included.
Yes.
Exceeding great and precious promises. Exceeding, comma.
Yes.
Great, comma. And
yes.
Precious
promises.
That by these promises.
Mm-hmm.
Which are exceeding great
yes.
And precious,
mm-hmm.
He might. So it's not automatic.
Yes.
It's a condition. He might.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That why he might changes.
Means that there's a possibility that you want.
You have a risk. If you don't meet your part of the bargain.
Yes, sir.
You will not enjoy that. Mm-hmm. Because it's not that every it is available, given to everybody,
yes.
But it will not be enjoyed by everybody.
Availability, access. Availability, access.
You know, you understand,
mm-hmm.
You appropriate.
Yes.
You don't know,
mm-hmm.
You don't understand, you will only be quoting scriptures without appropriating the reality.
Wow. Wow.
That by this he might be partakers of the
divine nature.
The nature. Find that. Now get into that divine
nature. Yes. That's the end game. For us to be partakers
of the divine that is the end.
Nature. Going back to where you said, now it is no longer ashamed to call us brethren.
Brothers. So we carry the nature, the DNA of his father.
Yes.
The same DNA we have.
Mm-hmm.
The father is full of glory.
Yes.
He said he called you to glory.
Glory and virtue.
Even your sonship is glorious.
Mm.
He said he killed one son so that he can bring many sons into glory, not into shame.
Mm.
You can't say you are a child, you are a son of God.
Mm-hmm.
No, if you are a child, you are not there, you are not in that mix.
Mm.
Is for sons. Glory is for sons.
And that's why Galatians 4, it says,
as long as
he is a child.
It means under tutors?
Yes. It differs nothing from a servant.
A slave is better than him.
Mm.
As long as a son.
Yes.
Remain. Who keeps him a child? Paul said, when I was
a child,
I did what? Thought like a child. Understood like a child.
Mm-hmm.
But when I became a man, I put away childish things.
Yes, sir.
Simply put, to be childly is okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's a stage.
Mm.
To be childish.
Or to remain childish.
To be childish.
Yes.
Is an irresponsibility. Because childishness is not a stage. That's an acquired status.
Mm-hmm.
The day you, there are things you will know.
Yes, sir.
That you can't stay in that state anymore.
Mm.
That status has to change. Mm-hmm. You grow, you become.
Yes.
So nobody's being a man is not a gift.
Mm.
It's a function of
growth.
I grow into sonship, into maturity, that I can begin to emit glory.
Mm.
I can begin to emit virtue.
Mm-hmm.
I begin to showcase excellences of God.
Yes.
1 Peter 2:9 said that we go to show forth the excellences of him who has called us out of darkness. To show off.
You know, we dealt with that a little bit of that last Sunday.
Oh, glorious.
We were saying God not only called us, 2 Corinthians 1, verse 20 to 22,
yes.
That he that has anointed us, him that was called us and anointed us and establishes us, is God.
God.
And we're saying he has sealed us. He has put the seal
of his Holy Spirit.
Yes, of our lives. So back to what you're saying the nature, the end game here is for us to be partakers of the divine nature. Wow. By which he has given to us exceeding great and precious promises.
By this. Right.
Yes. So to bring it home, every believer has a responsibility.
No. God.
Yes.
Not to know about God.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very fundamental principle.
Yes, sir.
To know every believer.
Mm-hmm.
If there's going to be a change of experience.
Yes, sir.
In their walk with God.
Mm.
They have to labor to know who God is.
Right.
Who they are in God. And what is at their disposal.
What is the hope of
his calling.
His calling.
Again, here's that scripture, so we are doing some justice to
the Yes.
Do you know that scripture disqualifies you also try to brag about you don't have any calling.
In 30 seconds, just say something about that.
God is the one who knew why he created you in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So he has a specific purpose.
Right.
All assignment, all mission, all calling for you to come fulfill on the earth.
Right.
He thought you. You press product. Purpose precedes production.
That's right.
He thought what to do.
Yes.
Then he thought the only person who can do that is Pastor Felix.
That's right.
So, is that purpose, was it yours?
No.
It was his.
Is.
He decided something he needed to do and appointed you before the foundations of the world and anointed you to come do it.
Mm-hmm.
So, is it your calling?
No.
Uh-huh. Is it your purpose? He said, David served the purposes of God in his generation. And he rested. David had no purpose. He was fulfilling
his
purpose. He was fulfilling his calling.
Mm-hmm.
We don't find significance fulfilling what is ours.
Mm.
We find significance by being obedient to execute what is his
calling.
And his purpose. Because all things, again, go to your scripture. All things we are made by him.
And not just by him. this is sweet.
Glorious.
All by things him. Were made by him.
And for him.
And then Hebrews 1:3, he says he upholds all things by
the
power of his word. By the word of his power.
But not the power of his word. By the word
of his
power. Because the power of God, the word of God is the hiding place of God's power.
Mm.
I said last Sunday I was preaching and I said, if God flexed his muscle, Christ will come out.
Wow.
Because Christ is the muscle of God.
The power of God.
Power of God.
The wisdom of God. Man of God, we are out of time. I hope, I trust the Lord will find some opportunity again. I just want you to give us your final thoughts as we come to a close of this session today. And as you do that, also take time to just pray with our viewers today, with our the people who are listening in. Yes, sir.
I would want to encourage you. I also want to challenge you that what you are looking for is within reach.
Wow.
That this Christ Jesus who has saved you, who has brought you into the family of God, in the household of faith, has everything you need for life and for godliness. And he's not communicating these realities from the outside. He's communicating these realities from the inside. He dwells in the inside of you. Is your hope of glory.
Wow.
He has given you everything that pertains to this life and godliness, but you have to come to the knowing of what has been given for you to receive. Whatever you want, whatever you are going through, get to know that what you need, God has it.
Amen.
You have access to it by Christ, but it will take revelation knowledge, intimate knowledge, which is birthed in the place of communion with God, His Spirit and His Word. As you begin to see the realities of what Christ has already finished for you, you begin to walk practically in those realities. I see someone coming out of fear into faith.
Amen.
Out of worry into boldness. Out of discouragement into courage. Because what you are looking for is not being prepared. What you are looking for is ready.
Wow.
And you can receive it now and here. Because our God is now able.
Yes.
According to Ephesians 3:20. To do to you. For you, exceedingly, abundantly, above what you are able to ask, not even think.
Wow.
He can exceed it. When you come to the knowledge of this your Father, this your God, He says, that did not withhold His only begotten Son, Romans 8:32, will He not together with Him give you freely all things? There's someone you're watching now, you're sick. You're going through a difficult time in your life. Sickness, healing is not being prepared. Healing is ready by His stripes. Where? Receive your healing. It is ready now, waiting just for your knowing it is there. And the ability of Him that has promised for you to receive it. Receive your healing. Someone is at the verge of despair and discouragement. I come to tell you, you have Savior. The day you collected salvation, you collected peace, you collected joy, you collected fulfillment. What is lacking in your faith is still available in Christ. Go for it. Today you are not telling God to do what He has not done. You are receiving what He has already finished. And as you believe and come into the knowing of knowledge of what is already done for you, getting to know who He is, get to know who you are in Him and what is at your disposal, you are going to really walk in the realities of what Peter is talking about. Glory and excellence.
Amen.
See you there to the glory of God.
Amen and amen. Could you just pray for us and with us as we come to a close? Amen. Yes, please.
Father, thank you because of the power of your word. Thank you because of the working of your spirit. Thank you because of the realities of the finished work. Thank you that all things are prepared. All things are ready.
Yes.
All things are available in Christ, waiting to be accessed by this accurate, intimate knowledge of our God.
Yes.
And His ability to perform. We know you cannot lie.
Yes.
Whatever you've spoken, it is finished. Waiting for us to walk in the realities of it. I pray for our viewers right now, all over the world, despite and irregardless of what they are going through, the power of God is not limited.
Yes.
The might of our God is not limited. Step into their situation.
Yes.
Let the light of the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ begin to shine in them. Let the eyes of the understanding be enlightened. They can come to the knowledge of what is already ready for them.
Thank you, Jesus.
In God, they have no excuse for despondency, depression, sickness, fear, doubt, anxiety. We have no excuse to those things because Christ has given us peace, has given us joy, unspeakable, full of glory, has given us this peace that transcends all human understanding, that is able to garrison our minds and our hearts in Christ Jesus. And this Christ Jesus, if He's your Lord and your Savior, they are not only availability, you can find access.
Glory.
And begin to walk in the realities of these things. And you hear you are not born again. the Lord Jesus is not savior of your life, you can receive him today.
Yes.
You can receive his life. You can be initiated into the family of God, the family that gives you access to all things that are of God, by praying this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner in need of a savior. I acknowledge you as Lord and Savior of my life today. Forgive me of all my sins. Accept me as your child. Make me as one in the family of God. Today, I commit by the help of the Holy Ghost, walking in the light of this revelation all the days of my life, knowing that you are my Savior, you are my Lord, and you have even made me to be your brother by the reality of redemption. Thank you for bringing me and making me one in the family of God. I thank you for accepting me. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen.
And amen. 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 Wow. It's been a wonderful time just getting into the Word of God and getting to understand what is the hope of His calling. My hope and prayer and belief is that the Word, Jeremiah said, the Word, your Word was found and I ate it. I gave it room and your Word became to me the joy and rejoicing of my soul. I hope that as these words have been broken, this Word has been broken down, and as you found them, as it's been revealed to you, that you walk in the light of that revelation and that you go higher and remain anchored and grounded in this hope that He has called us to. Till next time, I say shalom and the Lord bless you, keep you, and do you good. Remember, He is a keeper of Israel. Oh, neither slumber nor sleep. We love you from the Dominion Assembly Church on Kiambu Road. We're praying for you that the Lord, Him who has called you, who is also faithful, will do and accomplish the things that concern you. God bless you. We'll see you next time. Amen.